Most people think snappy FPV freestyle moves come from raids, and yes, lower expo will make your drone react more sensitive, but what if I told you that the real secret to Juicy Sbang might not be in your raids, but in your throttle? Let's dive into this. So a while ago I made a video about raids and expo and how less expo makes your FPV freestyle moves feel more snappy and robotic. And that's true, raids definitely play a huge role in how aggressive your quad feels, but lately I discovered something that made an even bigger difference for me: throttle control. Because it turns out that if you really want those juicy, snappy Sbang moves, throttle might be just as important as your raids. Hey everyone, welcome to a brand new video. I hope you're all doing well. I'm doing fantastic because, you know, when we're out here, it's fantastic. Most of the time. Fall kicked in pretty hard this week. Maybe as you can hear, it's quite windy today, but it should be doable. I think fall is one of my favorite, most favorite seasons. And I think for the videos, it's nice. It's a better scenery, you know, I like the warmer colors. But yeah, the reality is, it's already fall. And that means the end of the season is coming closer and closer. So let's say we aim at the half of November. That means we have October, 1.5 months, I didn't realize that. 1.5 months left to improve or spang. Okay, that's enough chatter, let's get some drone in the air. When I first started experimenting with Juicy Sbang, I thought the secret was all in expo. Less expo equals more stick sensitivity, which gives you that robotic, snappy feel. And yes, if you want your quad to move like that, you need the right rates. But there's a way to give it an extra boost. Here's what I found. Before, when I went into a trick, I used to quickly blip the throttle and put it back to zero and then do the trick. The thing is, when I completely cut the throttle, my quad might still be agile, but when I just keep a little bit of throttle in, it suddenly feels way more responsive. Now, I'm not a scientist, but there's probably a good explanation for this. My guess would be that the motors need less time to accelerate when they're already spinning. Kind of like riding a bike. It's way easier to speed up when you're already rolling than starting from a dead stop. Right, I'm just going to show you. That's, I think that will be the best way. So one mistake I made a few months ago was I flew towards the object, I blipped the throttle, go to zero, and did something like that. So what I eventually found out is when I just hold the cruise throttle, so the throttle you hold when you just hold the same altitude like this, you know? So we just fly into the object, or not into, but like this, and then see, keep the same throttle. Then I turn into the move, and then I throttle like that. Then you, so that's when you blip it. You can also apply this when doing other rewinds, like more like underneath it. Like that. So same throttle. And you basically can apply this to all kinds of rewinds, also like this. No? Like that. Fucking noob! And you can also apply this to rewinds like this. Like when you do a roll and roll back, for instance, like this. Now it means it looks pretty clean, but it's not like snappy. So when I use the throttle at the end of the move, I hope this makes sense. I know I'm all over the place, but so it's basically, of course, when you're upside down, you don't want to throttle towards the ground, so you keep it zero. But as soon as you come at the end of the move, you blip it like this, and you also pull the sticks, the roll stick very hard. So if you combine it with the rewind,
and once I've heard from tuner Superfly Steve, shout out Steve, that spinning motors create a gyroscopic effect. They almost act like a mechanical D-term, trying to help the quad resist movement. You can test this yourself by arming your quad without props, holding it and shake it a little bit, and you'll feel how the motors try to hold the drone steady. That little bit of throttle can completely change how tight and snappy your freestyle tricks look and feel.
So there is actually a way you can put this to the test yourself. That's by doing a pack without going to zero throttle. I will show you. You fly and you keep that throttle the same and you start doing tricks. Now, this whole flying don't make sense, but this kind of stuff really helps me to get a certain feeling down. And guys, don't forget, I am also a noob trying and learning this and figure the secrets out. And sometimes you have to do weird ass shit, but I hope this makes sense.
There are some top FPV pilots who actually fly with relatively low rates and even a lot of expo. And on paper you think that will make their flying look slow and smooth. But when you watch their videos, their freestyle quads still look super snappy. And of course the right tune and parts might help as well. And I can only guess, but I'm pretty sure throttle control plays a huge role here as well.
In the meantime, the sun started shining, but the wind is really getting pretty rough right now. At least I can feel I start to drift, especially when I trying the stops on that bush over there. You know, I try to stop and then I drift away, which of course nothing has to do with my skills. It's the wind, guys. It's the freaking wind.
So next time you're out flying, don't just think about your rates. Experiment with your throttle. Try to keep it up slightly instead of cutting it completely. And play with the timing. You might be surprised how much snappier your freestyle flying becomes.